Hey guys, it's me again, and I made this video before about an hour ago. Didn't like how it went, so I figured I'd go back and redo it. My thoughts were kind of all over the place. Earlier today, there was a school shooting in Florida, and I wanted to discuss that. I'm a gun owner, and I'm a concealed carry gun owner as well. I live in Alabama, and it's commonplace down south. Just nothing to it. A gun is a gun, just a tool. But when these politicians use incidences like the school shooting earlier today, or that the club shootings in Florida, the last year before last, and they use those incidences to further their own anti-gun agenda. That's where it gets me. If Joe Bob doesn't like guns for whatever reason, that's fine. That's his own opinion. But no politician should use a situation like what happened today as more fuel to curb legal gun owners from having a gun. You may remember back in the early 1900s, about 100 or so years ago, they tried their best to curb the sale of alcohol. And we all know what happened. It didn't help. The Crown Lords, they were sending liquor from Canada to the States. They didn't stop it, There was no stopping it. So why did they think that trying their best to eventually outlaw guns, why do they think that's going to help? The average law-abiding citizen is not out there shooting up clubs or shooting up schools. So why make it hard for the average person like myself to own a gun? Why? I don't understand it, And instead of looking at each individual case, they immediately focus on guns. Immediately focus on guns. A gun is nothing more than a tool. The same as this right here, a video game controller. It's just a tool. So is a gun, so is a hammer, so is a screwdriver, so is a baseball bat to play baseball with. It's just a tool. But instead of focusing on that person's mental state, no, they focus on a gun. Instead of focusing on just the plain old evil in people's heart, they focus on the gun. Why? I can go get a sword right now and walk into a Walmart or a preschool or a church and stab a bunch of people, maybe even more than you could if you had a gun. Because you know what? I don't have to reload a sword. Stab, withdraw, and do it again. With a gun, you gotta remove the magazine, put a new one in. Or if it's revolver, hand load it. Our politicians are looking at the wrong thing, I don't have a problem with a 7-day waiting period. I don't have a problem with a 2-week waiting period. But when you don't look at the true issues, then that's all they have left, I suppose. And when you do your level best to limit a free person who's abiding by the law to own a gun to protect himself against the scum that you should be focused on, that's not right. And, you know, these kids go to school, they're being bullied. I understand that. I was bullied all through school, you know, the way I walk, the way I talk, you know. When I'm not wearing my contacts, I wear real thick glasses. No lie, they're really thick. I'm blind in my in my right eye, so you know I was picked at about that. So I know what it's like to be bullied, okay? But not one time, all through school, did I ever think of grabbing a gun and shooting a classmate. You know, that never crossed my mind. It never crossed my mind to go and grab a knife, come to school with a knife, and stab a classmate. Because you know what? Words, it's like water off a duck's back. Let it slide off you and keep on going. Ignore the stuff that comes out of folks' mouth, you know? But I will say this. When I was younger, and even now, I still believe it, my mom would tell us, if someone hits you, hit them back. And I still think that's what needs to be taught in schools today. Instead of these parents telling their kids, oh, well, go to a teacher, go to a principal. What are they going to do? Nothing. Maybe suspend you. Maybe have in-school suspension. Because today they can't spank you anymore. So what's running to a teacher or the principal going to do? No, you handle the situation right there like a man, fist to fist. I've had to do that 2 or 3 times in school that I remember. And 2 of those times, one that I know for sure, we wound up becoming best friends after we fought. You know? The other times, those guys left me alone. Once they know that you will stand up to them, man to man, chances are they'll leave you alone. But it doesn't give you the right to go and grab a gun and start shooting people. You handle it like a man, fist to fist, and that's it. That's the way we always did it, you know? We were taught to respect guns, you know, and not fear them. That's one thing I love about my generation. I just turned 40 about 4 days ago, last Friday. You know, we were taught to respect guns and look at it as what it is, just a tool. You know, these kids, I was just reading an article a few days ago, maybe last week or so sometime. And it was saying how 1 in 7 kids are diagnosed with ADHD or ADD, whatever you want to call it. I think there's 2 separate terms now. And I'm going to say this. I could be wrong. I'm no expert in that field. But knowing how Big Pharma is, I don't trust them. And it wouldn't shock me if they just made up this whole ADHD stuff just to sell pills. Kids have always been fidgety, you know. If a teacher isn't teaching a subject that's going to make that topic interesting to them, of course they're going to fidget. They're going to doodle in their notebooks. They're going to pass notes to Joe Bob, you know. That's not a reason to put kids on dope. But it's an easy way to get the kid to settle down so the teacher can teach if that's what they're doing. Plenty of times when I was growing up, the teacher was teaching stuff and my mind was everywhere except what I was supposed to be listening to. Why? Because it was either boring, I just didn't care about the subject, or she didn't make it interesting to me, you know? Did that mean, oh, I was hyperactive in this and that? No. You know, and with these kids being, you know, and I wonder, with these Big Pharma pushing pills on these kids at 7 to 8 years old. What is that doing to them? We know already that some of the bad side effects are suicidal thoughts, increased aggression. So let's just say that, for instance, just this whoever started this shooting in Florida, whether it was a he or a she, let's say they did have this ADHD stuff. And let's say for 6 or 7 or 8 years they were on these pills. Don't you think that's going to affect them in some kind of way? This is what they need to be focused on. The mental health aspect of it. What are they taking? And I know it's easy to get your hands on a gun. I know that. But instead of focusing on just the gun issue, focus on what's up in here. What is that kid going through? Was he being bullied because he's transgender? Was he being bullied because of he's gay? Was he being bullied because of this or that or the other? But no, the politicians don't want to look at that stuff. And the media doesn't want to look at that stuff. They'd rather keep pushing this fear gun agenda, And that's what I don't understand. If you don't like guns, fine. But don't look at Joe Bob as being the bad guy just because he walks into an Olive Garden or a TGI Fridays with a gun on his hip. Because that very person that you're quick to judge could probably save your life one day. If an active shooter happens to walk into a Fridays or an Olive Garden or anywhere else. They're focused on all the wrong things, whether it be laws or this or that. And that's why I just don't understand it. Because look at 9/11. After that incident happened, did we just sit back and let a bunch of bullies hit us and not do anything? No. So why should a parent tell their kids to, hey, if somebody hits you, punch you, don't do anything, just take it. Go run to the principal. No, you stand up for yourself. Stand up for yourself and fight back man to man with fists. And don't run, grab a gun, I don't understand these people nowadays, and it's I don't get it. Maybe it's because of the fact that guns are just so easy to grab. That's what they just grab that and go handle their problems at school or at a club or what have you. But I think they're looking at the wrong issues, And coming up with laws to hurt the average law-abiding citizen so he can't afford a gun is just wrong. That's wrong. I don't buy it. And I thank God for these lobbyists who will come up and these organizations that will stand against all that stuff, Because a gun has never done anything to me. It's the person holding the gun. And before I'll blame an inanimate object over something that the owner did, I'll look at that person and say, hey man, why did you do this? What is it in here or in here that made you think it was cool to go grab a gun and shoot somebody? But our lawmakers in DC and within our own state houses don't look at it that way. And so I wonder, how come they don't do the same thing when it comes to drunk driving? They're not going after Anheuser-Busch. They're not going after Jack Daniels. They're not going after whatever alcohol company out there. But if you're going to blame a gun for a school shooting, then blame the alcohol for a drunk driving accident. What's the difference? It's a double standard, you know? It's a double standard. But yet, when there's a drunk driving accident, what do? They don't go to the liquor companies. They go straight to that person and say, "Hey, why'd you do this? You know you drank too much. You know your blood alcohol content is point something or whatever." But yet, when it comes to the gun situation, they break their necks trying to come up with new laws. But yet, they don't do that when there's a drunk driving accident. If anything, they just up the drinking age, you know, or whatever, to 21 or whatever it is, you know? I don't get it. So, let me get off my soapbox and film some video game footage. All right, guys.